Hello friends, welcome back to LearningStrome Academy. So friend, if you haven't pressed our subscribe button or bell icon, so please subscribe it or press the bell icon so you can directly get our videos. Okay, so friend, today the topic that we have to discuss is floating point literals. So friend, what are the floating point literals? So friend, in the last video I actually discussed about the integer literals, and actually friend, as you know, what are literals? As I also explained in my video, okay, what are literals? So friend, actually the constant value are the literals, okay. So now we are more specifically discussing about the floating point literals, and so friend, in this video we are going to discuss what are the actually way to assign a floating point literal to float data type and double data type, okay, and what are the various valid acceptable form for the floating point literal, okay, and what are the compile time error we are going to get for the form that are not valid, okay. So friend, these are the thing that we are going to discuss in this video, okay. So friend, let's start with the video. So friend, actually what are the floating point literals? So friend, floating point literals are the values that have decimal point, okay, with it, okay. So this is the floating point literals, okay friend. So if I'm going to assign a floating point literal to a float data type, in that case friend, I have to fix it with small f and capital F, okay. So this is the way to assign a floating point literal to float data type. But if I'm going to assign a floating point literal to double data type, in that case I don't need to suffix it with small d or capital D, just because our compiler treat any decimal value as a by default as a double data type, okay. A compiler treat any decimal value as a double data literal, okay. So friend, see, if I'm going to assign my floating decimal value to float value float data type in such a way, in that case I'm going to get a compile time error because I'm not suffixing even small f and capital F, okay. And this is a valid form actually, okay. This is the valid form in which I'm going to assign a value to this, okay. This is actually not invalid, this is a valid form, okay. So friend, now what are the valid forms of way to assign an integer floating point literals, okay. So friend, the only way valid form is a decimal form, okay. We can assign our all floating point literal only in decimal form, okay. We cannot assign like octal form and binary form and hexadecimal form like integer literals, okay. The only form in which we can assign our floating point literals is which form friends, on the is the decimal form, okay. So friend, but these are the valid statement in Java. Why friends? So we will discuss about this in example. So let's see the examples friend. So very first point that I have to tell you friend, that if I want to assign a floating point literal for data type, then what is the way, okay. So let's see friend, if I'm assigning this value, okay, to float data type, in that case friend, I'm going to get an compile time error friends. The compile time error will be incompatible types, okay. See, we are getting an incompatible type, okay. We cannot convert double type to in float, okay, just because friend, as I tell you, if I want to assign in float literal to float data type, in that case I have to suffix with small f and capital F, okay. See friend, now my program is working fine, okay. So this is the first point. If I want to assign floating point literal to float data type, in that case I have to suffix it with small f and capital F, okay friend. So the second point, if I'm going to assign this value to double data type, okay, in that case I'm not going to get an error, just because our compiler treat any decimal value to as a float data type, okay. See, I'm not getting any compile time error, or my program is also running fine, I'm getting a right value, okay. So this is the second way to assign a floating point literal to double data type, okay. We can assign a floating decimal value directly to double data type without suffixing with small d or capital D, okay. So this is not a mandatory part. So this is the second part, okay. So friend, as I tell you, the only valid form for the decimal value or floating point literals is a decimal form, okay. So friend, but this is also working fine. If I'm going to suffix it with zero, it's mean that I'm going to represent my octal floating point value in octal number, okay. But as I said you, the octal form and the other form is not acceptable for the floating point letter, na? But it is working fine. Why, friends? So let's see. If I'm going to get a compile, it is not generating compile time error. Even it is not going to generate a runtime error, and it is going to print me a value that I'm assigning it. So it's mean that, friend. Now from here you get to know one difference, that it is not an octal value. My compiler is not treating it as an octal value. Actually, when I assign a 0, my compiler is going to just ignore that 0 and going to take rest part and as a decimal value and going to print that value. See, I'm getting an exact value 123.124, okay, not and printing it. Okay, my compiler is treating this number simply as a decimal number, not treating it as an octal number. Okay, so this is the point that you have to remember, friend, and you should notice that that whenever I'm going to assign a octal value, octal literal, and when I'm going to represent my floating point value in octal form, in that case my compiler is not going to treat it as an octal number, and in that case my compiler is going to treat simply as a decimal number. Okay, so this is the point that you should remember it, and you should notice it. Okay, friend. So this is the point. Okay, see, if I'm going to assign an integer integer letter in the octal form, in that case, friend, actually what will happen, my compiler is first going to convert this octal value to decimal value, and then it is going to give me corresponding value to that octal value. See, I'm getting 83, which is a decimal value corresponding to this octal value. Okay, so it's mean that, friend, when we assign a floating point letter in octal form, in that case actually this is not an octal form. Our compiler just ignore that 0 and print that value. Okay, simply. Okay, so this is the third point that I have discussed with you all. Octal values are not acceptable for the floating point letters. Actually, just our compiler ignores 0 and treat dash part as a decimal number. Okay, if I'm going to use going to assign hexadecimal value, friend, in that case what will actually happen? So let's see, friend, actually what will happen. Let's save this number and program and then compile it again. Friends, we are going to get a compile time error malform floating point letter. So friend, this is the fourth case that I have to discuss with you all. Whenever I'm going to assign going to represent my floating point letter in hexadecimal form, in that case, friend, we are going to get a compile time error, which is not the case with the octal form. In octal form, we are not getting any compile time error or runtime error. In that case, our compiler just behaving smartly and ignoring the zero and treating the rest part as a decimal number and printing it. But it is not a case with the hexadecimal floating point letters. In that case, we are going to get a compile time error, and that compile time error is malform floating point letter. So friend, remember it, keep in mind that we are not going to get we are going to get a compile time error for the floating point letter in the hexadecimal form. Okay, so this is now you can see this is also not a valid form for the hexadecimal. Okay, so for the floating point letter. Okay, and the last thing, that binary numbers. Okay, so friend, binary numbers also not a valid form for the floating point letters. Okay, so as I discussed with the floating point letter, octal and for floating point letter, octal and binary and hexadecimal, these are the not are the valid forms. Okay, so see, friend, these are also not a valid form. In that case also we are going to get in compile time error. So friends, keep in mind when we are going to send floating point literals in form hexadecimal and binary form, in that case we are going to get a compile time error. But in octal form, we are in the case with octal form, in that case we are not going to get a compile time error. Okay, so this is the difference that you should keep in mind when we are getting compile time error and when we are not getting compile time error. Okay, so this is the case. Okay, friend. Okay, so as I was showing you in the example, this is the acceptable form. Okay, so why this is acceptable? Okay, see, I am assigning a binary value to a double number, but I said we cannot assign a binary value to double number. Okay, but it will work fine. So friend, why it will work fine? So let's see, let me tell you why. Yeah, I'm getting the right value. Actually, friend, this is not a floating point letter. This is actually, friend, integer letter. Yeah, actually, this is integer letter, and I'm representing the integer letter in the binary form. As we know, we can assign an integer value to float that type. Okay, actually my compiler is going to typecast that integer value to float that type. Okay, and this is acceptable. So friend, here we are assigning our integer value in which form, in a form, any form, and my compiler is going to accept that form value and going to assign my to my double data type. Okay, that's my friend, this is working fine. Okay, this is not a floating vulnerable. Actually, this is, if it is a floating vulnerable, in that case we are going to get a compile time error. Okay, see friend, there is no decimal point. Okay, it means that is a normally integer literal, and integer literals are acceptable by the floating literal. That's why it is working fine. Okay, as we know, we can assign our float integer literal in any form, in any form, in either in correct hexadecimal and or binary or octal form, all the way will be acceptable. Okay, see if I'm going to assign a hexadecimal value, okay, hexadecimal value to it, again it is going to work fine. Why? Just because this is not a floating point literal, this is a actually integer literal. So, okay, see, I'm getting a right corresponding value to this hexadecimal value. Actually, this is a friend, what actually this is a actually this is a integer literal. See, again I'm assigning integer literal, and again I'm going to work, my program is going to work fine. Okay, so this is the reason friend, if I'm going, we can represent our integer literal in any form. Okay, this form will be valid. Okay, but we cannot represent our floating point literal to any form. In that case we are going to get in compile time error. Okay, so don't be confused between these two things. Okay, so keep in mind friend, what are the compile time error that we got get. Okay, and in which case we will get a compile time error, in which case we will not get a compile time error. Okay, so don't confuse with this representation. Okay, and the binary form representation of the floating point literals. Okay, so friend, thank you. In next video we will talk about the character literals. Okay, so friend, keep share our video and do subscribe and share with your friends more and more, and also give us feedback and comment feedback so we can improvise our content more and more if you feel like that. Okay, thank you friend, bye bye.